Cha-cha.
A rookie sensation.
Jackson Storm.
Jackson Storm.
Jackson Storm in a class of his own.
Hey, champ. You had a good run.
You have no idea what a pleasure it is for me to finally beat you.
Did you say meet or beat?
I think you heard me.
Cars 3 is directed by Brian Fee and stars Owen Wilson as Lightning McQueen. You couldn't forget good old Lightning McQueen. But it also stars Nathan Fillion and Armie Hammer as well as that annoying guy that plays that annoying character. Yeah, this one. So Cars 3 is about Lightning McQueen. He's actually getting old. He's a senior among racers now. He's like getting really good. All these rookies are coming through. They're electric cars. They're faster than him. And he's starting to lose his value and his respect, like people's respect for him. So what happens is that he puts his entire career on the line of the first, of one race. So he ends up getting this trainer. The trainer's called Cruz Ramirez. So Cruz Ramirez has to train Lightning McQueen to get better and actually beat the rookies and become a great racer once again, continue racing forever. Now, I'll say this about Cars 3. It is by far the best Cars movie because it has the least Mater. I mean, you know, after that first movie, everyone was just like, make Mater the main character. And they were just like, yeah, sure, we'll make him the main character. You know what? We'll make him a spy as well. And everyone was like, that was terrible. Why would you do that? Who would suggest such a thing? Give us Buck-a-choo. And they're like, you know what? Yeah, we will try and put him in as little in the next movie as possible. And they did. And it was a good thing for it. Thank goodness they realized they screwed up. Congratulations, Pixar. You fixed yourself slightly. The animation as well is also really beautiful. The scenery itself, it looks like it's been shot outside and they've just sort of animated in talking and moving cars because the scenery is absolutely beautiful. It all looks really realistic. I also really like the new designs of the cars. Those are also really cool as well. And the voice acting from everyone's very solid. Nathan Fillion was a great agent manager and Armie Hammer was sort of a convincing-ish 20-ish person. As per tradition with all Pixar movies, it sort of hits you in the feels when it has to. It doesn't do it as effectively as any other Pixar movie. I would say Cars is definitely the weakest at doing that, but they hit it to a point where you go, that was touching. Really, really touching. But I can say this, the best part of the Cars franchise and this Cars movie is the racing scenes. The racing scenes are really impressive. The sound design is so great, and just love the racing. It's just watching the race is so much fun. It's like, I love cars. I love the cars. Cars racing are great. But I'll say this, there isn't that much to talk about cars. It's just one of those kids movies. Just like, hey, you can get something out of this and they can get something out of this. But it's really not something that you have to go out and see straight away. But I will say that Cars 3 is one and done. Have you seen Cars 3? What did you think of it? What's your favorite movie out of the Cars trilogy? Let me know in the comments down below. Like you did if you enjoyed it, and subscribe, comment on the Platypus. See you guys next time. Bye.
Oh, wow, you made it to the end of the video. Good job. How about you click that subscribe button for more content? Or click one of these two videos. You know, either one's good enough.